गुड मॉर्निंग प्रतिभा। सो शैल वी स्टार्ट? शैल वी स्टार्ट? गुड मॉर्निंग जया। ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास we have dealt with the problem of Stokes theorem. Now in this session I have given you one problem, that what do you understand by the term line charge. So most of you have written it, and I guess maximum people have written from internet the same line which I can read there. So today I will tell you the physical meaning of line charge, surface charge density and volume charge density, and we will solve some problem there. And after solving problem you will be clear with that line charge, surface charge and volume charge. So for today's topic is line charge, surface charge and volume charge density. So these three terms we are regularly using, so we are not aware of the physical meaning of line charge and how the problem is coming based on the line charge. So basically line charge means that, so suppose that if you are having any object like wire, and that wire, if you induce the amount of charge on that, so then line charge will be equal to the total amount of charge upon the length of the wire. So what I'm telling you is, suppose one wire is there, let's suppose this is the wire which we are having, and we wanted to find out the line charge in this wire. So for example, सर वॉइस कट रहा है, सो इज इट प्रॉब्लम विथ एवरीबडी? इज दिस प्रॉब्लम विथ एवरीबडी? एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल? एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल? सो हमेशा चेक योर नेटवर्क, आई थिंक बिकॉज ऑफ योर नेटवर्क इट इज क्रिएटिंग द प्रॉब्लम. सो जस्ट मूव ऑन. सो बेसिकली लाइन चार्ज मीन्स दैट if you are, suppose this wire is our object, and in that wire if you are inducing amount of current, so if I am putting or depoting some amount of current here, that is Q. So what if you wanted to find out the what is the line charge on this wire, so line charge on this wire will be equal to the total amount of charge on the wire upon the length of the wire. So this will be the line charge for that wire. So this is actually the meaning of the line charge is there. So I think it is clear with you. So sometimes they will ask that, sometimes the charge distribution is a function of coordinates, means the charge they will ask. So here we are calculating the total amount of charge here, total amount of line charge. So sometimes they will ask at this point or any other point. So sometimes they will ask you to calculate the line charge on this point. So in that case, if the charge distribution is according to the coordinates, so if they are asking you to find out the line charge of this point, so if I am taking this as a dl, and I am empowering dq amount of charge on this dl, so for this wire, full wire, I have put q amount of charge here. But if they are asking for this certain point, and if the certain point is like dl, and if I am powering dq amount of charge there, so how we will define the line charge in that case? So as we are aware that line charge is equal to the total charge upon the length of the wire, so in that case dq will be the total charge, because we are considering only this length. We are considering only this, and they are asking you to calculate on these coordinates. Various coordinates are there. So in the starting I have told you the line charge for the full wire, but if they are asking you to calculate only on this point, so how to calculate line charge on this point, so I will write the formula here. So we will denoting the line charge by rho l equal to dq upon total charge will be dl. So we are calculating, we are having problem to the connection to the network. if you are feeling any kind of difficulties in the voice, or so you can tell me in between, because I can't know that you are facing the problem. So please tell me in between. So what will be the formula for this? So dl dq upon dl, because for this area, cross sectional area, we are finding the line charge. So what I will get from here, that dq equal to rho l dl. This will be our, so as we know that for charge, what we will do, so if we will do integration of dq, we will get here q, that will be the total charge we have done in the previous problems. So I can write here like this, dq equal to q equal to rho l dl. So based on this and based on this, we will find some numericals, and that numericals are important for your papers and all. So simple numericals are there based on line charge, surface charge. So what I wanted to show you, that you should know the physical meaning of line charge, how, what is line charge, where we need to calculate, what is the cross sectional area in the line charge. So these physical meaning you need to be aware from that. So one formula is this one and second formula is this, so you will be please aware of that. So now we will move to the surface charge density. So if you are having any doubt on the line charge, you can ask in between. So some of people are leaving the meeting in between, so I don't know the reason. So if you are having any doubt in line charge, please tell me. So now you understand what is line charge, why we need to calculate line charge. So hello, I am audible to you all. वॉइस नहीं आ रही है. ओके, आई विल ट्राई वन सेकंड, आई विल टेक वन अदर. ओके, आई विल टेक वन अदर हेडफोन, जस्ट वेट फॉर अ सेकंड. So am I audible now? Hello? Am I audible now? So okay, so if any problem is there in between, please tell me. So this is the line charge. So line charge will be defined as the total charge of the wire upon the length of the wire. And if you wanted to find line charge on some cross-sectional area or some coordinate, because in this case we are assuming that for the full wire, but if you wanted to find the lines for this coordinates or for this coordinates at some certain point, if we wanted to find the line charge, what we will do, we will take as dl for this point, and we will empower dq amount of charge in that dl. So the formula will become rho l will be equal to dq by dl. So as we know that when we will integrate this dq, we will get q, that is total amount of charge, and that is equal to rho l dl we have derived here, because this will be the cross multiplication. So this is the line charge. Line charge basically if you want to define line charge, means if you have any object like wire, and in that wire if you have induced the amount of current, the line charge will be equal to the total amount of charge upon the total length of the wire. So if you are having any doubt in the line charge, first of all I will make you to understand the physical meaning of line charge, surface charge, volume charge, then we will solve some numerical based on that, and after that you will get a clear idea for this. So if you have any doubt in this line charge, please tell me. Are you having any doubt in this? So should we move on? Okay, so we'll move to, if you will face any difficulties in my voice, you can tell me in between. Okay, so we'll move to surface charge. We'll quickly finish all this line charge, surface charge, and volume charge. We'll see some couple of examples here, and after solving the examples, we'll be more clear with the problem. So second one is surface charge. So basically, let us say that we have one surface here. We are assuming that this is our one surface here, and if I deposit some q amount of, so this is our surface as I'm denoting it by s, and if I'm depositing some q amount of charge here on this surface, so some q amount of charge is deposited on this full surface. So like same like line charge, the surface charge will be equal to the total charge upon area of surface. Total charge upon area of surface. So this will be, so we'll find area in the given problem based on the given coordinates. And but if sometimes they will, so this is what, this is the total surface of this, this will denote the total surface. If they are asking you to find on this certain point, if they will ask you to find charge on this point, or if they will ask you to find the charge on this point or this point, so if they will asking you to find the charge on the certain coordinates, so if I am taking it as ds, and if I am powering dq amount of charge on ds, so what I will get here, surface charge will be equal to dq by ds, and in that case dq will be equal to rho s ds. And we already know that if we'll do integration of dq, what we'll get, we'll get q, so we'll be equal to q, this will be equal to rho s ds. So this will be the formula for surface charge density. And basically surface charge is very important for the capacitor, because as you are all aware that capacitors are having two parallel plates, so in that case this is getting a, what is this square is like having a surface charge, these are also having the parallel plates here. So these surface charges are very important for the capacitor, because these are having parallel plates, so they will ask you to find the surface on the capacitor on any of the coordinates of the capacitor. So like that question will come. So this is all about surface charge. So now I will move to volume charge density, and now after that we will solve some problem there. So after, I think now you are getting the point what I'm telling you. So after solving the problem, you will get the full idea based on line charge, surface charge and all of this. So now we'll move to volume charge density. So the third is volume charge density. This is also same. So all you need to find in the surface charge, the area of the surface, and in the volume charge, you will take the area of the volume. So suppose that any random volume I am taking here. So this is our, so the total volume will be equal to V, and total amount of charge is deposited is Q. So what will be the volume charge? The volume charge will be equal to total charge which has deposited, that is Q upon total volume of the object. What will be the total volume for that object? That will be the rho V. So sometimes it is having a function of coordinate, and they will ask you to calculate change on that given volume. So if they will ask you to find on this volume, or they will ask you to find on this volume or in this volume, so what we will do, we will suppose that this volume will be dV, and we were powering some dq amount of charge on dV. So what we will get here? So rho V will be equal to dq by dV, and therefore dq will be equal to rho V into dV. So if I'll integrate this, what I'll get here? dq equal to q equal to rho V into dV. So that is all about volume charge, line charge and surface charge. So I think now you are having a clear idea of all this. Now we will solve some problem based on this, and after solving the problems, you will get full idea based on this line charge, surface charge and all these things. So let's write one example here. So please write one example here. I will show you how to solve the problem, how the problems are basically coming into your paper. So we'll solve one problem here in this case. Suppose question is like this, the question which are coming, and this kind of questions are definitely coming in from the second unit of your topic. So like suppose the question is like that, if the line charge, please write the question, if the line charge density, and all these things which I am teaching now will come in the picture in the coming sessions. So you should be clear with the line charge, surface and volume charge. So we will directly using the formula there, directly using the concept of line charge there. So you will not get confused. So if the line charge density will be given, rho L is given as rho L which is line charge, and they are asking you to find the total charge on y-axis . This is the question. So whenever the question is coming on EMFT, you just need to study the question one or two times, you will get an idea. So this is the question. Please write the question. After that, I will try to solve this. So please write it, because take a copy pen, then solve it. Because when you will solve here, you will get an idea, and when you will see only, then it will be. So it will be not. I think it will be not remembered by you. So try it by yourself also. So what the question is like that? That if the line charge density rho L is given as 24 J joule square millicoulomb upon meter, find the total charge on y-axis from -5 to +5. So this is the question which we are having, which are dealing with. So suppose this is a line charge. So first of all, we'll draw the figure. So this is our line charge. Full line charge is there. So the coordinates which are given on the, so suppose I am considering this as the y-axis here. I am considering it as y-axis, and the coordinates which are given, the y-axis is varying from -5. So this is -5 and this is +5. This is varying from this point to this point. This point to this point. This is varying from -5 to +5. And rho L is given as 24 y square. This is y square, I guess. This is y square, because this, we are dealing with the y coordinates. Y square meter cube by meter. So this is the question, rho L, that is given to us. So we need to find this question. So we have already solved those kind of problem in the earlier session. So we are aware of the fact that Q will be equal to integration of line charge into dl. So we are aware of this formula which we have dealt. So what I will just substitute the value here. So I will write here 24 y square dy. So and into 10 to the power 5, -3, because you can see the unit of this meter cube upon meter. So I will write here 10 to the power -3. And this, the limit which I am going to put is from minus, this is varying from -5 to +5. So now the problem is solved. Now you just need to solve those, this integration, and you will get the answer. So I think everybody is capable of solving this integration. So I will take this constant term outside. So after taking this constant term outside, now we need to find the integration y cube by q, and the limit is varying from -5 to +5. So if you solve this, this will be 8 into 10 to the power -3, 125 plus 125. So when you will solve this, you will get or 2 coulomb. So this will be the final answer, and this type of simple question will come into your paper for 2 marks. So if you are aware of this, you can easily solve. So if you are having any doubt in this question, please tell me. So am I audible to you all? So now it is clear, Aditi. Now also you are facing the difficulty. Now the voice is clear or not? Please tell me. वॉइस नहीं आ रहा है, अभी अभी रुक गया था मैं बीच में, इसलिए नहीं आ रहा होगा. अभी आ रहा है आवाज आपको, क्लियर आ रहा है? नाउ हेलो, नाउ आई एम ऑडिबल. Now it is audible to you all. Please tell me why. Okay, so I'll write one more question here. So if it is not audible, so we will. So I will write one more question here. So try to solve your, try to solve it. So if voice is not, if voice is not, so if voice is not clear, kindly note the question. And see the step. And in any, if any problem is there, ask me in comment section. That's all I can do because I can't clear the voice, so it is not in my hand. So if first question is clear to you, I'm going to write the second question. And if you are not having, if you are not having any clarity, we will close this class and we will try to take it on some other time. So I'm just for the sake, I'm writing the question. You just need to try it by yourself. So if a square plate is given as a square plate resulting in XY plane, it's situated in the space defined by find the total charge So this is the question: a square plate resulting in XY plane is situated in the space defined by the coordinates which are given for X minus, it is varying from minus 3 to plus 3, and for Y it is varying from minus 3 to plus 3. Find the total charge on the plate if surface density is given as rho s equal to 4y square micro coulomb by meter square. So if this question is clear to you, please tell me. Is this question clear? Can you see the question and can you hear my voice? So can you see the question and can you hear my voice? Am I audible to you all? Hello. हेलो आदित्य, आवाज नहीं आ रहा क्या?
विजिबल भी नहीं है और ऑडिबल भी नहीं है।
ठीक है, तो आप बोल दीजिएगा क्लास 2 बजे कंटिन्यू होगी। हाँ, अभी पता नहीं क्या दिक्कत हो रहा है, तो 2 बजे क्लास कंटिन्यू होगी अभी मीटिंग छोड़ने के लिए। ठीक, सो वी मीट एट 2 PM। सो वी विल ट्राई टू मीट एट 2 PM फॉर दिस टाइम। यू कैन लीव द मीटिंग, वी विल ट्राई टू मीट एट 2 PM।